Hey y'all, it's Betsy from Happily Ever After, etc. and Lily, my cat, and I am back with another project. So today, Lily wants to be in the video. Say hi, Lily. Say hi. Today, I'm going to be showing you how to make a silicone mold that you can pour resin into out of any shape. So this is a freeform mold. So as long as you can draw it, you can make it. We're gonna be making circles so that we can do a three-tier tray. I've used this same technique to make an oval, to make an actual tray. A lot of y'all might be coming from that video because everyone over there has been asking me how to make a mold like this for a while and I haven't had a chance to put the video up. So without further ado, I'm going to show you everything you need and then we will get started. This is a really easy way to do a mold. So I can do it, you can do it. All right, first things first, you need a base. So I typically start with a baking pan. That way I can actually pick my project up. I can move it left, right in the house. I tend to work outside since it's most ventilated, even though I do wear a respirator when I do resin. I just don't like to subject anyone in my house to the resin smell. I have a lot of animals, including my little cat. So I work outside where they don't have to smell the resin. The baking pan makes it really easy to pick up my project and let it dry in the craft room. So you're going to put on top of that a silicone mat. Now, this is what I use to do all of my molds on because resin is going to peel off of this. Once you've made your mold, you've poured your resin in, you want the resin to be able to come out, okay? Now, silicone sticks to silicone. So if you use a silicone mat, I think they're like $9 for a set of three, so about $3 for a mat. If you use a silicone mat, your mold will be permanent. You can reuse it. They last a really long time. So for things that I'm going to be making multiples of, like I make multiple trays, I use a silicone mat. If you do not necessarily need it to be reusable, you just want to make one project and be done, you can use a piece of acetate, which is just a clear plastic sheet. You can get these at most craft stores or office stores. You can order them online. Now obviously this is smaller. They're typically 8.5 by 11, although you can find them bigger some places. So keep that in mind when you're doing your project, but you can usually get a whole box of these for a couple dollars. So they're a great way to make a mold that you're not gonna use them a lot of times. Okay, so now that we've got our base done, you need a tube of silicone. As long as it says 100% silicone, you're good to go. That's what you need. It doesn't necessarily matter the brand. This is the one that I'm using for this project. I've used a bunch of different brands, and as long as it says 100% silicone, it doesn't matter. Typically, I use clear just because I feel like it's nicest to be able to see my project, but it doesn't matter if it's colored. And then you need a caulk gun. I like this one. It says it's dripless. I don't know how. I mean, it's not touching this. How does that matter? You understand why a caulk gun can be dripless. Put that down below. I would like to know. But it works real well. It has our little piercer so we can pierce the top, and it just works well. It's cheap. That's the goal. And that's pretty much all we need. You also may need some paper towels and scissors if you need to cut the top of your caulk tube off, things like that. But basically, we're all set. So we're going to jump right into this project and get started. You'll start by, need a little more leverage, cutting the top of your tube off, and then you'll have to poke inside. Got one cut off already. You see inside here, you'll have to poke your little guy here through that foil, okay? Once you've done that, you'll be ready to go. So, all we're gonna do is start by tracing our shape. Now what I'm making is a three-tiered tray. So I've got three of these set up. This is my middle layer, my top layer of the tray. And you can totally freehand this, but since I am doing a three-tiered tray, I want my tiers to be, you know, big size, middle size, little size, and I want them to be just a little bit different. So see, if I lay the top layer over my middle layer, you can see how those will look when they're done. So I've got two baking pans, ran out of baking pans, so I'm using a cardboard box for my tray on the third one. And all we're gonna do is trace the shape, then we'll remove my fancy schmancy mold here, and we'll keep going. We wanna go four layers high. So we'll do one layer, move on to the next one. We'll let that sit for about five minutes. And then we'll do the second layer. And once we've done four layers high, we should be ready to go. So since these are circles, I just got two paper towels and cut a circle, and that makes it super easy to cut. Let's get started. So you want to try to trace as close to the outside as possible, since we are trying to make a specific shape, but we're going to take the paper towel out. So if you go over the paper towel, it's really not that big a deal. You want to try to use as consistent pressure as possible. And typically I try to make my bead pretty thick because you want your wall pretty thick. But I can always come back and add a second layer and make it thicker. And since these are going to be kind of geode inspired, I just did a tray this exact same way. With handles, it's gonna go with the set. I'm gonna do a whole table together. So if you saw the edges of that one, I'll link it down below. You know what I mean. I don't want the edges of this to be perfectly smooth. I want them to be a little rigid, like how a stone or a geode naturally would be. So it is fine to me that it is not perfect. If you want it to be perfect, then that is something you will have to work on. You can also smooth it out with a glove, and I like to use a bit of water and Dawn dish soap on the inside of your circle once you're done, if you want to make sure it's smooth. All right, so now we are going to just let that dry. I'm actually gonna punch a little bit here because that was starting to fall over. So if you get a little bit falling over, you can just beef up the outside. So now I'm going to take this out. And we'll be good to go. So these little bits inside where it kind of followed the paper towel, I'm just going to go back in with a bit of paper towel and kind of push those outward. I don't necessarily want the bottom of my mold to have indents there. Looks like I need a little more silicone over here, so I'll probably add a little bit more. And silicone is not super smelly like resin, but I am outside of my porch mainly because this is the most level place for me to do big projects like this. You definitely want to be on a level surface. but you don't need to wear a respirator to work with this like you will when you get to the resin portion. And you can really make just about any shape that you wanted to, like this. Like I said, I just freehanded the tree I did last week. These I followed a little mold of that paper towel. You could easily, if you were super talented, which I am not, draw whatever shape you wanted. I could do circles and trays. I couldn't do like a freehand horse or something. I don't know what you would want to make a freehand mold of. There we go. All right, so that looks good. We're gonna go ahead and move on to the next one and let this sit up for 5 minutes. Technically, it doesn't need to be 5 minutes exactly. We're gonna do this one and then we'll do the big one. And then by that time, we'll come back and do another layer on this one. And like I said, we're gonna go 4 layers high, and then we'll probably do another, at least one layer on the outside, just to help it kind of stand up. All right, ready for this one? So now that you've seen this, I'm gonna finish this guy and then I'm just gonna time lapse it for you, because honestly, you've seen me go around this circle once, you get the idea. You really do. And as far as the silicone goes, the tubes here, I ordered off of Amazon, but you can get them at your Walmart as well. Of course, trying not to go to the store right now, staying home. So Amazon it is. But they're like $5-6. They're not expensive, which is why I love them for stuff like this. Because larger silicone molds are quite expensive. I think I said in my last video that a silicone mold for a large tray, like the one I did last week, would be $40 to $50. I have to imagine one for a 3-tier tray like this would be a similar price. I do have round silicone molds that are not worn as expensive that were like $10-$15. But the sizes on those were much smaller as opposed to the ones that I'm making here. I mean, this is the middle size. So for a tube of silicone, I can make a mold like this. And that tube of silicone goes a long way. I'm using the same tube that I used to make the tray last week. I still haven't run out. And I've done a couple other projects with it in the meantime. I'm going to make a mold with some actual silicone mix after this. And I used my silicone tube to shore up the tray that I'm using for that one. So a tube goes quite a long way, which is good. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and move this guy and move his littlest friend. Goodbye, little friend. And we're gonna get my big one. Now this one I've put on a round tray because that's what I had. And since it is round, I just went ahead and taped the mat down on the bottom. That way, every time I pick this up, those edges don't go flying like they were doing. But when you make a mold like this, you'll see by the time we're done, I'm gonna make it pretty thick. When I made my first tray, I only made it 4 levels high and 1 layer thick, like this, 1 layer thick, as opposed to doing a second layer on the outside. And when I went to pour resin in it,
it wasn't 100% leaky, but it definitely had leaks coming out the sides. So I've learned how to kind of avoid that by doing that second layer on the outside. And that helps when your silicone is falling over, but it also helps plug up any leaks you may have. So I will show you how to do all of that. And by making it so thick as to prevent leaks, you also make your mold quite durable, which means you can use it for more than one piece. I've made several trays with my other mold, not just one. So it's not like this is a disposable mold necessarily. You can definitely use it as many times as you like. All right, that one actually looks pretty good. You do want to avoid getting silicone on the inside of your mat like that as much as possible, because naturally resin, silicone resists resin. That's kind of the thing, you know? I mean, that's why it works. It's because silicone resists resin. So anything that you get in the middle here will help resist resin, which on a big piece like this will just put a divot in your bottom layer. But that's not ideal, so when you can, avoid it. If you can't, try to wipe it up before it dries. There we go. Perfect. We are going to go ahead and let that dry and go back to our first round. I don't think you can see it, but my silicone tube that I set to the side here is totally dripping silicone everywhere. So that's why I put this freezer paper down to protect my porch. It's a wooden porch and I don't want it to be siliconed. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and time lapse y'all so that we can get 3 to 4 layers on all of these. Good luck. Wish me luck. Well, it just goes to show ya that as soon as we start a time lapse, we'll run out of silicone. Look at that. That's the whole tube gone. All right, well, we are going to put that one in the trash. So this is the one that I've already, I don't know why I keep thinking I can do that on camera. I can't. I don't have enough grip strength to do it that far in front of me. So we're just gonna go ahead and poke this. There we go. That'll give us our hole there. Now, this one, since I'd already cut it off, I'm gonna show you. It's already down here, and that's because I'm an idiot, and I don't want you to be an idiot. I didn't realize, I've used caulk a million times before, but I guess I've never opened one. I don't know if my husband's opened them for me, or my dad, or my mom, or somebody else, but I guess I've never gotten one I had to open, because I didn't realize you have to pierce that foil the first time. And I just pushed it all the way down there thinking it wasn't working. It was working, but it was coming out the back and my entire caulk gun, like, can you see that? It's still a little messy because I cleaned it up as best I could, but did not like that. And this is the result. I pulled this out of here this morning. This much silicone was in the back of that. It's dried now, I pulled it out, and we should be able to use this just fine. But this is what happens if you don't pierce down inside of the little tube there. So don't do that. Don't be like me. Be better. do it the right way, you'll thank me. So this should work perfectly fine now, but I guess we'll find out. We'll squeeze it till it starts coming out the front. There we go. Magic. When you do it the right way, it's magic, you guys. Dun, 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 dun. And go back to time-lapsing. Don't be like me. Be better than me. Okay, so when you get to your third and fourth layer, you may get problems like right here, where the silicone A starts to fall over a little bit, or B, I can't really show you, but when you have three layers, say these are your three layers, even if they're right on top of each other, they may end up start having little gaps. And so the best way I've found to handle that, say there's a little gap right here, you can push it back in on itself this way, and that helps. But the best way to handle that is what I've done here, and that is that you fill that gap with some silicone, and then you pull it back this way by securing it to the base, and see how that just like straightens up your wall there. It also plugs any holes that you may have, so that silicone or resin from the inside won't come out. So I tend to do that all the way around as needed, and then at the end I'll show you, I'll plug up the holes and go all the way around so that there's no spills, so that it's sturdier, and so that it'll last longer. All right, let's keep going. Okay guys, so now that we've done all four layers, you saw me in a couple places go in, and we are gonna do that all the way around. So you just wanna stick your silicone tube down at the bottom, and you're gonna squeeze and just fill in all the way around with silicone. So I do this whenever I want a mold to be used for a while. There we go. You don't have to overdo it, that should be enough. But you just want to make sure any holes all the way around the piece are plugged up. And then what I do is, when I fill it with resin, when I'm making my first layer, or if I'm filling it up to the top, whatever the case may be, I'll let the resin, after I'm done, if I'm just pouring it in, I'll wait at least 10 minutes and I'll just sit here and watch. And if resin starts to come out any of the sides, I know there's a hole, and I can just stick my silicone gun right where the resin's coming out and plug it right up. You don't want to do that on the top here, because the wet silicone will stick to the wet resin and it's not good. You can fix it, but it involves a lot of dremeling, a lot of sanding, a lot of X-Acto knifing. So try to avoid that. But there you go. That's what it looks like. Now, since my piece is going to be kind of stone geode inspired, I'm going to leave all these rough edges inside where there's 3-4 layers and all the blobs and everything. I'm going to leave that. I like that on the inside or the outsides of my piece. But if I wanted this to be a smooth piece, then in between layers, as I was going, I would have used a glove and some water and Dawn dish soap to smooth that out and made it just be even. You're never gonna get it 100% perfect, just because we're people, we're not machines. Unless you're a machine, I'm a people. But you can get it pretty smooth. If you do leave it like this, even though I do want it to be
imperfect, just keep in mind that imperfect and jagged are two different things. So you will need to sand your edges when you leave your mold like this. I use a Dremel to smooth them out. It's pretty fast and easy. You can use just hand sandpaper. It will take a while, but it is doable. All right. I'm gonna put you on fast forward. All right, y'all, and that is how you make a silicone mold with a silicone mat and some 100% silicone from the hardware store. So now we are just going to go ahead and let this fully dry. I like to let mine cure overnight. It's a little bit overkill, but I just feel better about it. So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna set these aside in a clean, dry room. Keep them level, and then we can fill them with resin tomorrow, and we will make our three-tier tray. All right, y'all. So once you've finished your whole project and it has dried, typically the tube says anywhere from 40 minutes to 4 hours, but silicone and resin together do not mix. Bad things happen when you put wet resin into wet silicone. So I just like to be safe. I let mine sit overnight. I think I said that already. But, ta-da! This is what our mold will look like when it's completely dry. Now you'll notice that mine's not on a baking pan right now. That's because I've already done my resin project. This is in the future. And I've actually made my three-tier tray. That should be up on the blog soon. But you can see exactly how the inside of this works. So that is what the inside of your mold will look like. It's ridged. So if you're not a fan of that, before the silicone dries, just smooth that out with your finger. But you can see how sturdy this is. Like, this is not coming off. When I first made these, I had been told that it would peel off and that you could reuse the silicone mat for a different shape. I think I might have even said that in this video. I'll put a disclaimer over that, but that is wrong. Silicone sticks to silicone, okay guys? So this is permanent. I could cut off these edges, but I will be able to make a million different ones of these over and over again. I can always add a little more silicone to the inside if I think I need to, but they are, I mean, I could re-pour into it right now, make another one. So it's a great way to make a mold for a couple bucks. For a set of three, I think it came out to like $14 for all three of them. Whereas one mold in the larger size is like 40, 50 bucks. So makes me happy. But if you watch the whole video, this is the middle size tray. We've got our baby tray, the green, and the big daddy, our pink tray. So, what are you making your molds today? Leave a comment down below. I want to know what you're making and if you like this video. Thanks, guys. Don't forget to subscribe, give me a like, all the things. I'm not very great at all the YouTube spiel, but you know what to do. See you next time.